Okay, we will start double overtime here. Jump ball. And Chester wins the tip again. Lowry gets the ball. Sends it up to White. White looks, stops, he pops. He misses. Rebound Freeman. Up and good, the power move. Isaiah Freeman. And Chester takes the early lead here in the second overtime period. Anthony Murray comes down for Penwood. Screened by Borward. Somebody needs to call that out. Might lose it. Borward inside. Back out. Purnell shoots, he misses. And rebound Freeman, back to Lowry. Lowry to White. Chester looks to set something up. You want to get the good shot here. Womack looks. Whoa, bad pass. Here's a Purnell. Purnell drives, spins, throws anything up. Freeman with the rebound. Sets up to Womack. Womack to White. White looking to drive. Euro step. He scores. Chester's up 4, 64-60. And here comes Fountain. Fountain looks to drive. Fountain up top. Trying to go around a Borward screen. Borward looks for Murray. Murray. Again, he's trying to set up a Borward screen. Being hounded by White. Murray. And he throws it away. Penwood turnover. We have a disgruntled Penwood fan. Leaving from where I'm at, and good riddance for him. Official timeout. Murray the time to snicker. Now, the offense looks a little different now. Chester's up 4. No rush here. Both teams are in a double bonus. So Chester can look for the good shot here. Again, they don't have to shoot threes. Look for the good shot, probably going to the basket. Pembroke extends their D. Womack up top. Womack trying to put the five count. He goes around it. Womack looks. White. Freeman. Lowry. Good ball movement by Chester. Something we didn't see earlier. We're seeing it now. Lowry back to Womack. Womack to Lowry. Lowry up top. Back to Womack. Let's see if Penwood fouls here. They don't have to. White has Purnell on him. Shot didn't call a foul there. Womack looks. Drives. Ah! But off of Murray. And Chester was lucky on that one. And Chester called a timeout. A full timeout. So we have 1:48 remaining in the second overtime. Chester up 4. 64-60. Right now, Chester running in motion and spread offense. It seems to be working as it's taking Penwood out of position and also has nullified Shillingsford, who I have right now with 6 blocks. So long as they keep them spread out a lot, Chester should be successful. Again, will Penwood play straight D here or will they foul? So right now the clock is not on their side, it's on Chester's. Again for Penwood, Borward, Murray, Fountain, Purnell, and Shillingsford for the Penwood Patriots. Matt Linneman barking out instructions. For Chester, we have Lowry, Freeman, Womack, White, and Jerkins. Freeman to inbound. And looking. Oh, bad pass. Smart foul there by White. Not a good pass there by Chester. And the thing you didn't want to do is put Penwood on the line with no time moving. But then again, you also wanted to stop the breakaway. So the Sadiq Fountain at the line for Penwood, he'll shoot too. Now let's see if the Chester cheerleaders can distract him. And he misses the first. And the Chester cheerleaders have done their job so far. Let's see if it works again. Penn will now call their defensive play in case they make it. He makes the second one. Better than Freeman. Freeman power dribbles out to Lowry. Lowry to Womack. Dangerous pass. Womack smart. Brings it back out. Chester's up one possession. And the Womack. And they call the foul first. And he almost traveled. And Coach Taylor's telling him to move the ball. And that foul was on Evan Borwitt, and he fouled out. So that was his fifth. Their team is over the limit. And coming for him will be number 13, Jalen Mahan. So Womack will go to the line. He'll shoot two. And he definitely needs to make the first one. Well, he needs to make both. Yeah. So he makes the second. Makes the second, makes it a two-possession game. And he makes it. So now two-possession game. Chester up four. Chester playing straight man. Fountain comes it down. They're looking to get Murray. And stolen by Freeman. Freeman to White. And Chester looking here to take time off the clock. Back to Freeman. They have to hurry up and get it over. Give it to White. And White throws it away. And Mahan scores. Not a smart move there for Chester. Lowry goes to the basket and he scores. Great move as he caught Penwood napping on the D. Chester back up four. Again, no threes. As soon as I say that, they make one. Timeout Penwood. And as we said earlier, you have to guard against the three-point shot here. So now Chester's only up one, 37.6. Yeah, Chester napped on a defensive assignment. Left Fountain open. He's not known as a three-point shooter, but he's been looking to shoot them. And at this time of the game, you know Penwood would. Okay, we have 38.4 here in the second overtime period. Chester's ball, they will take it underneath the baseline underneath Penwood's basket. And you can expect Penwood here to, with a trap. And they have a little bit more length and they're trying to trap Chester's smaller guards. Chester, for the most part, has broken the press. It's just been the passing has been a little scary. But you would think with three point guards on the floor, they should be able to handle themselves. And Freeman will look to inbound the pass ball for Chester. You have Brilliant White on one up at the top key. Lowry behind him. Here they go. Tipped away from Fountain. And some time should have gone off that clock. That ball was touched. But it wasn't. Jerkins gets the ball. Jerkins dribbles out. Jerkins to Womack. Womack to the basket. Oh, they're calling for a player control off of the foul. Wow. Great defense there by Pentwood. Took a big risk. And now Pentwood can actually hold for the last shot. Unbelievable. Hit the clip joint. Pernellis to take it out. And Pentwood throws it away. Does anybody want to win this game? All right. So Lowry will inbound for Chester. Call a stack play. They give it to White. White dribbles out. Luckily, Freeman was there. And Freeman was fouled. Freeman gets to go to the line, gets to shoot two. And fouls on number 14. Fountain. And Isaiah Freeman's at the line, he'll shoot two. Again, 23.6. And he misses the first. Has to make this one. Has to make this one. Premier makes the second. Chester's up two. And here comes the trap right here. Oh, Purnell almost lost that when he comes down the right side. And ball in Murray's hand. Look for them to shoot a three. He shoots a two instead. He misses. Freeman with the rebound. Shocked. They thought they would go for three on that one. And I tell you, Anthony Murray is spit. As he's played a fine game for Pentwood. But Chester will go to the line here. Kadir Lowry with 8.2. He makes both of these. That's the ball game. He makes the first. Here's the all-important second shot. He makes them both. Chester's up four. And here comes Fountain down the side. Lowry's on him. Murray shoots. And that's the ball game here from the clip joint. And Chester wins a barn burner here. Chester wins it 70-66 in double overtime. We're trying to get a picture of the scoreboard. I think even my phone is tired. Here we go. Let's see if we get a picture of the scoreboard. Still didn't get it, but Chester wins and they advance to 4-1 on a young season. Pentwood falls to 2-2. And again, Chester wins in double overtime here. If you watched it all on CMPRadio.net, Clipper 1-0 in the Del Valle, 4-1 overall. Tomorrow they take on the defending 6A champions, Reading Red Knights. And again, you've seen all the action, as you will tomorrow on CMPAUradio.net. I'm James Peach Howard. Good night here from the Clip Joint. See you tomorrow.